Welcome to Sino Technologies. Spring Cloud with microservices and weekend classes demo it is. What are the prerequisites are required to attend this 2 days workshop? The prerequisite is Spring Boot and REST APIs. If you are not good at Spring Boot and REST APIs, then attend weekend classes of Spring Boot in Sino Tech so that you will get in-depth knowledge on Spring Boot. Let us start demo. Why microservices are introduced into market? What is necessity of these microservices? Before microservices in the market, most of the applications developed earlier using monolithic architecture. Before microservices, most of the applications developed using monolithic architecture. Hey, what is mean by this monolithic architecture? What is mean by this monolithic applications? Monolithic applications are applications where all the features of application is present in one single deployable artifact. See now, that means monolithic application is single code base. Monolithic applications are single code base. That means all the features are available in single code base. See now here. There is e-commerce application. If e-commerce application, let's assume that all these features of your e-commerce applications, like product, like shopping cart, like orders application, like customers applications, all the features are in single code base and all the features are in single WAR file. That is single deployable file. See, what is the drawbacks with the single deployable file and what is the drawbacks with the single code base? Now here see, in your real time, in production, most of the production servers are more than one. Based on the traffic, based on the real time customers traffic, number of servers will be decided. Let us assume that this is a one var file. It is another same var file is running on two servers, means two instances. Another request will come. Load balancers will be decided. Which server is free? Request will go to that server. What is the drawback here? You know, if you want to scale your applications, see, let's assume that in your real time, the traffic, products traffic will be more, and shopping cart orders, customer traffic will be very less. If you see it here, if you go Amazon.in, if you see this Amazon.in, product feature traffic would be more, but shopping cart traffic would be very less. Orders traffic will be very less. See what is happening here, you know, even though the product traffic is more, but shopping cart order history customer traffic will be very less. What you are doing, even though your traffic is only for one of the features, but still you need to scale whole application. What are the drawback with the scaling of whole applications? You know, the drawback of scaling of whole applications, unnecessarily you need to the resources. So the resources means the CPU and RAM. You need to spend, you know, the product is taking only for 6 GB only, but even though product is taking only for less resources, but you need to scale whole application. Scale whole applications means huge resources are required here. Huge resources are required here. Understood here? See, your actual requirement is only 6 GB only, but you need to scale. You need to take one more new system and deploying your whole application into new system. That new system will take more resources. The first drawback with the monolithic applications is that there are so many drawbacks are available with this monolithic applications. That's why industry is slowly moved into microservices. First drawback is scaling issue. Due to that, resource utilization is not proper. Resource utilization is not proper. You need to scale your whole applications, even though if you want to scale only for product future, but you need to scale here whole applications, means resources here, utilization is not proper here. Second one is tight coupling team. What is mean by tight coupling? See, it is the monolithic application. See, according to your project requirement, you need to modify only product catalog code changes only, but there may be impact for other features also. We are not sure. That means if you are trying to modify one of the future, there may be a chance to impact on other features also. What you should do? You need to do more regression testing and more functional testing of other features also. It is called tightly coupling here. That means tight coupling means if we are trying to modify one of the future code changes, then it may impact on other features also. It is impossible for other features also. So due to this, what happened? See, development time. So here we need to do more functional testing and regression testing. We need to do more functional testing and regression testing for other features. So it will take more time, team. It will take more time. That means here the development time would be more, and development time and QA timelines will be increased team. See, all monolithic applications are tightly coupled team. Now third one is single point of failure. What is mean by single point of failure means? Please try to understand. If you understand, it is easy. So go to here. Hey, if you are trying to, let us assume that your application is not working, server is not working, or any one of the feature is not working, then whole application will not work. Means if one of the feature or server stop working, then whole application will stop working. So it is a single point of failure team. If one of the feature or server stop working, then whole application will stop working team. It is the drawback of these monolithic applications. Next one is difficult to enabled CI/CD means, since all the features are enabled into single deployable, it will take more time to build and deploy and execute unit test cases, all the reports, it will take more time team. That means monolithic applications are difficult to enable since all the features are in single deployable artifacts, then it will take more time to build and deploy. That is difficult to enable, build and deploy automatically. Now, fifth one thing. What is fifth one? Most of the monolithic applications are using on-prem servers. Hey, if you are using on-prem server, means the server which are owned by our companies, on-prem servers, our own infrastructure. That is the infrastructure which is owned by us. There are some challenges with this monolithic application team, this on-prem server. On-prem servers challenges are, one is performance. Another one is high availability. Always our application should be high availability. Always it should be okay, up and running. Third one, what is the third one? Auto scaling team. Now, fourth one, data loss prevention. Now, fifth one team, zero downtime upgrade. These days, market is expecting all the features, but if we are using monolithic architecture, all these monolithic architectures are, most of the applications are is built on on-prem servers. These on-prem servers may not be support all the features. Do you think always YouTube will be up and running? No. So if it is using monolithic applications, compulsory there is a downtime, performance issues, availability issues, auto scaling issues, data loss prevention issues, all these issues would be happen if you use monolithic applications because of it is using on-prem servers. Hey, to overcome all these problems, now here market started using new architecture is called microservices. Now, what is mean by this microservices team? Now, please try to understand. Microservices. Now, here see. These are number one, microservices. Microservices are distributed, loosely coupled, software objects. software objects that carry out small number of well defined task. Carry out small number of well defined task. Another one is the micro services are small autonomous services which are responsible for one kind of functionality, which are responsible for one kind of functionality or features. Now the biggest question in market is, okay, everyone is asking, how do you split monolithic application into micro services? Now answer is, see, there are two things are there. One is okay, SRP in solid principle. SRP means single responsible principle. Another one is, there is a concept is called bounded context. What is meant by this bounded in context? Splitting monolithic into micro services based on the business functions team. That means, now if you see, hey, I'm splitting whole your monolithic applications into different micro services. Product is a one feature, shopping cart is a one feature, order history is a one feature, customer feature is a one feature. Earlier whole into single deployable artifact. Now every micro service its own code repo, Git repository. Earlier it was different. All are loosely coupled. Its own deployable artifact. All are loosely coupled team. Separate CI and CD would be there. All are loosely coupled team. So what is the advantage of with this loosely coupled here? See now. So it is a separate code base, separate deployable it is. It's not, it's a individual deployment. It's not depending on other things. Individual deployable artifacts. All individual deployable artifacts team. That means now here see, for product service, four instances are there. So it will require for only 6 GB. For shopping cart in production, three instances are required. For order history in production, only two instances are required. See, it is always recommended splitting this monolithic applications into micro services. How? Using bounded context, splitting monolithic applications into micro services based on the function. The first advantage with the micro services is scaling is proper, resource utilization is good. First advantage with the features of these microservices. Features of these microservices. Now step one, scaling. Scaling is easily. Now here every feature of micro service is separate code base. separate code base so that scaling is good and resource utilization is proper resource utilization we have means you no need to deploy whole application which feature of the application is required only that feature only you can able to scale it and add it to new server okay next one is loosely coupled what is mean by loosely coupled team loosely coupled means now here see change in one feature or one service it should not to break other services it should not to break other services that means if we see if the shopping cart is done only shopping cart page only will be done product is up and running order is up and running customer also is okay up and running in your whole application if any one of the feature is down that feature page only it will give error message remaining all it is able to see of up and running it is not in single point of contact it is not in single point of failure if any one of the server is down then it should not impact your whole application that is if any one of the service is down then it should not impact whole application only that feature will be down that is only that whole application is down that is only that feature would be down only that feature would be down okay remaining whole features and application is up and running application is working properly understood team so now next one team every microservice so if you see here you can scale it is required on 4 instances because more traffic will be coming to products only it is required only to order stream will come to less traffic it is required for only 3 because shopping cart would be more traffic next one thing every microservice should have its own database every microservice should have its own database team okay its own database that means see your product and service should talk to product db only order service should talk to order db only your order service should not talk to product db if your order service need product details then your order service will call one REST API call to this product service and the product service will call to database and it will get the details and give to your order service it is not recommended multiple services should calling same database that is the reason so every microservice it's a isolation it should be its own database team you know most of the microservice architecture should use cloud as infrastructure it is very important team hey if you use cloud they should use cloud infrastructure they should use cloud not on premises infrastructure they should use cloud infrastructure not you know they should not use on premises of infrastructure. If you are using cloud means, if you are using cloud means what? If you use cloud, cloud will take care all physical servers and all. Cloud will take care infrastructure changes. Cloud will take care. Once your infrastructure is ready, your performance of your application is good, all the features, whatever the features are there, your high availability will be there. Okay, next one, no data loss preventions. So you should have always, what are the features are available here? All the features, if you are using cloud, zero downtime. There is no downtime. Okay, if you use cloud, see here, high performance would be there, auto scaling would be there, data loss prevention should not be there, zero downtime should be there. All these features you have to implement if you are using any cloud based applications team. Please try to understand, if you are using any cloud based applications team. Understood, right? So that's why market is crazy on these micro services. Remember, micro service is not a technology. Micro service is not an API or is not an technology. Is not an API, is not an technologies. It is a architectural style. Architectural style means it's a theory, it's a process. How you will take this theory, you will implement it its own way. Architectural style. It is a architectural style. So using this microservice architecture, using the microservices architecture, we can build large scale applications. We can build large scale complex business applications. Again, hey, microservice is not a technology, it is an architectural. Architectural style means for what? It's a theory, it's a concept. Take this theory and the concept, how you are presenting, it's up to you. That's why microservices is nothing but not only for technologies. Along with technologies, to fulfill all the requirement, you need some tools. Along with the tools, you need some infrastructure changes also is required, team. But developer is focusing on these two. Infrastructure will be focusing on the cloud side, team. So what are the tools are provided? There are many tools provided in market to fulfill microservice, to fulfill microservice based architecture. Architecture projects. Understood, team? Architecture projects. So now here, see, now what are the tools are there? Tools means, okay, Netflix has provided some tools, team. So before Spring only, Netflix has come into the picture. Netflix has provided some tools is called Eureka Server, and tools are called and Hystrix. Okay, Hystrix, Zipkin Joule. And so many are there, team. See, to implement our requirement, you need to know all these tools also, team. Microservice is nothing but APIs plus tools plus infrastructure, team. See, what this guy will do, Our Spring guys has introduced a one model is called Spring Cloud. Spring Cloud will adopt. Spring Cloud has adopt these tools from Netflix. Adopt this tool from Netflix and build a and okay developing a and okay developing a microservice based architecture application developing microservice based or microservice based applications. Applications means if you want to learn this micro services, you should be strong how to develop the REST APIs using Spring Boot, and you should strong on some tools like Eureka, Istrix, Zipkin and all will take care everything. I will explain clearly. You don't worry about these tools and also infrastructure. Either you should use any one of the cloud or infrastructure. You should use AWS, you should use Azure, you should use GCP, any one of the infrastructure, you should use it to team. So to keep in this mind, how our structure, syllabus, we have designed for this microservices course means, now here see practically how it works. Introduction, chapter one, introduction to Spring Boot and REST API basics we will discuss. And the cloud characteristics, what are the characteristics are required for your client and you know how to implement each and every characteristics with practically what is horizontal scaling and what is vertical scaling, what is the difference between monolithic applications and microservice applications, what is the microservice architecture, how to split your monolithic applications into microservices. Chapter 2, Spring Cloud evaluation. How the Spring Cloud guys using this Netflix tools like Eureka, okay, and Joule, Istrix, Sleuth, how all the features of Eureka, okay, how the all the features of Netflix has been used by this Spring Cloud here. Now, Spring Cloud server and config management. That means how to do the how to make your configure as a centralized, how to make your configure as a how to make all your application configurations to move from your local application to centralized applications. That is the concept is called Spring Cloud config server, Spring Cloud config kind. First, we would be explained what is the problem statement, what is the solution requirement, how to implement. Practically, I will be showing practical and it will give it to your team. Next one, what is service discovery using Netflix? How this, what are the problems would be there before Netflix and how to register our microservices with Eureka discovery, how to get the instances from Eureka discovery, how to test it, all everything we should be provided in chapter 4. Chapter 5, how to communicate from one microservice to another microservice, how many use cases are there. One of the use case is called discovery client, another use case is called load balancing or ribbon client, another use case is called Fegan client. Use all these features to communicate from one microservice to another microservice team. Now next one, how the resilient of your applications means how to implement circuit breaker, how to implement resilience 4J, how to implement this time later, all we are going into see practically team. Next one, Spring Cloud Gateway means instead of calling all the microservices by your consumer or your client, you will be exposing only one endpoint. Using that endpoint, your Spring Cloud Gateway based on the URI, it will be route the request to particular resources. After that, the distributed logging and centralized logging team, we are going into use Sleuth and Zipkin And also ELK, ELK stands for, okay, elastic, log stress and Kibana. How to distribute your logging in your real time? How can you say your logs? How can you trace your logs for last 1 week, last 1 month, last 2 months? How can you get it these logs using, you know, there is a dashboard is called ELK. ELK is, you know, logging aggregation tools. Whereas Sleuth and Zipkin is, you know, Sleuth and Zipkin is distributed logging creation. ELK is logging aggregation. It will aggregate all the logs. It will display on the your, you know, it will, okay, display on the your ELK dashboard, Kibana dashboard. After that, security. First time we are going to implement in the market OAuth. It's not a theory team. How practically this OAuth will work? What is the, you know, resource owner, resource server, authorization, everything we are going into see practically and will be, okay, explained on this OAuth 2.0. After that, microservices services with Docker and Kubernetes. How to develop the applications using microservices, you know. So here, how to use this Docker and Kubernetes. Last, we will discuss about top 50 questions, you know, or top 20 real-time questions on microservices. Those questions more than enough to crack the interview team. So again, our highlights team, what is the highlights of this course? Please, okay, what is the okay, highlights? Number one, hands-on development training team. That is every example in 2 days workshop, every example theory and practical implementation, implementation from the scratch. I would explain team theory and practical implementation from the scratch. I will explain team. Another one is, it is completely interview oriented classes team. That means after 2 days weekend class, 2 days weekend class, you can attend interviews on, you can attend okay interviews on Spring Cloud with the micro services team. Trust me, that kind of stuff we are going into provide. Okay, Spring Cloud and micro services. Understood team? Now last one. Hey, for your practice, right? We will provide 2 days class notes and we will provide okay examples. What examples we are going to discuss in the classroom? That okay, examples, you know, we are going into providing to you, and also videos for a few days how to access your 2 days weekend classes. These are the highlights we are going into show team. So we have okay, discussed till now what is the difference between monolithic applications and microservice, you know, how to split your monolithic and microservices. What are the technologies are required in microservices? Not only for one technologies, you may need so many okay, technologies are required. So technologies plus tools plus okay, infrastructure is called microservice architecture team. Otherwise, you cannot say that microservice architecture. Understood team? Any questions? You can ask me. Now, please, those who are okay, interested, please okay, registered from okay, http://www.srinutech.com. You can okay, register from here so that before 1 day we will send email on, you know, confirmation students will send email so that they can okay, attend for this 2 days weekend classes team. Once again, I am showing all the syllabus. This whatever point here mentioned here, it is my responsibility. I shouldn't cover everything team, and okay, from basics to in depth we are going into see practically team. Understood team? Yeah, thank you all. We'll catch up on our 2 days weekend classes team. Yeah, thank you all.